Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your next team coming to the stage as per usual.
Some of my generic poses here, alright? You tell me which one you like, okay? You ready? Is that again?
That's great, man, but we're not doing print. We're doing commercial. Yeah, so you're going to be speaking in this.
Okay. All right, sure. Whatever you need, my friend.
Did you memorize the dialogue before you got here?
Yeah, hang on a second. All right, give it to me.
You're really not going to want to do that. The casting directors don't like that shit, man. Trust me.
It's okay. All right, whatever you say, my friend.
I've been through this.
Yo, let's have it.
I've been you one day.
Hey, I'm prepared. Right. You saw my
and
poses.
Someone told me what I'm telling you what right now to do. You want to book this job?
Bring it.
You want to make your agents happy?
JCPenney's going to make my career, my friend. That's why I'm here right now.
All right, here we go.
Go.
Take one.
Go. What am I doing?
I just hit the button, dude.
I'm sorry.
All right, I'll call action.
I'm a little confused.
All right, here, you ready?
Yep.
Go ahead.
JCPenney, number one.
Dude, that's not the fucking...
Cut. I know what this needs. I know what this shoot needs. Y'all are so 1985. We gotta bring it into the millennium. It's 2015. We need photobombs.
Thank you.
We need random people walking up behind the set, just jumping in, making crazy faces. I think that's what our campaign needs.
I think we can do that. You want to feed me the line again? Give me the line again. All right. Hang on a sec. Let me try it my way. Let me add a little sugar and spice to this.
We'll try it your way.
All right?
We'll try it your way.
Look, let me try it back again. All right, you ready?
Action.
JCPenney, number one.
Honey, happy anniversary. I bought you this robe.
Oh, well, thank you.
Open it. Okay. It's a robe.
Yes, I can see that. It's very nice and fluffy.
Yeah, it was on sale.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, okay. Wednesday special? Yeah, the manager came up to me and said, it's Thursday. I said, you want more? I better check my schedule.
No.
Turns out it was Thursday.
You're just so supportive of me. I just love it.
I love you very much.
And I love too.
I got another present. It's chocolates. You'll open it later when we go to the fair. I'm going to surprise you with a ring. And I'm going to engage.
So, bet you think you're hot shit now. Big cover boy, JCPenney.
I don't think I'm hot shit, man. I know I'm hot
shit. I was there once.
What are you telling me?
I'm telling you, your life is gonna suck.
Bullshit!
Not now, not tomorrow, but soon, and, well, for the rest of your life.
Look, when you get to the top of the JCPenney modeling list, you get all the names you want, or guys.
I've been there. See, that's the thing. You're there, you're by yourself.
Honey, it's Ralph Nader from the JCPenney Act!
Oh my god, my favorite!
In your face! Don't scratch
it!
In your face!
Will you sign my chest? Oh, thank god!
Hang on a second.
I can die!
That's nice.
He's signing my wife's chest!
Yes!
High five!
Gilbert Nelson, 1981.
He's not in the new catalog. Sorry, wish book.
Underwear, tiny whiteys?
You don't recognize him, do you? Hey, look, some sugar and spice for you guys. Look, here's a little more.
There it is!
Oh, my God. Shit!
That's the pose. That's it.
We're here today to honor the JCPenney CEO for providing these great employees pennies for all these years. We have a couple of employees that want to say a couple words about the CEO and everything he's done for you guys.
Well, if I could start, my name's Chet Wilder. I started JCPenney's in 03, after the denim crisis. They started me out at 5 pennies, and I thought, reasonable. I worked my ass off, penny after penny, and now... I'm a penny short of a quarter. Where would I be if it wasn't for this man right here? I love you, man.
Thank you for everything you do for us as employees. I mean, if we didn't have a boss like you, where would we be, really?
Shh, nowhere. This is where you're going.
Thanks, boss.
No, I'm pulling the plug on this whole operation. I've had my run. I've seen your faces. I've made you happy. That's all that I needed in life.
Fuck this podium!
Yeah,
God damn it!
You do that. You do that, but you're gonna have to pay for it.
You! All these years, man!
Yeah.
All these years!
Yeah.
I brought you out. We gathered here. This celebration. And this is what you're gonna do to us?
You should have got a 401k.
Can I have a ride home with someone?
Take care.
We don't get a bonus?
I guess you let us go, man. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, that's... No, yeah,
you're gonna have to walk or something. I really wish you would get those new things you can, just stand on and it kind of moves.
Well, I bought some shoes with some skates on the bottom from here, but...
Well, that's enough.
It's JCPenney. They broke in half.
Oh.
What about my discount? Do I get the discount still?
Well, maybe one time after you come in here just as a favor. And then after that, maybe an apology letter from JCPenney would do?
Well, I mean, if we're making apologies, I'd just like to say that I... Last month, I stole a pair of black socks for my aunt's funeral.
Dude, man, that's fucked up.
I actually stole a pair of perfume.
We are gathered here today to pay homage to our wonderful Aunt Gertrude.
Poor, poor Gertrude.
It was a horrible accident.
Very terrible accident. An acid.
Okay. That would look really nice with my black pants.
Excuse me, I've got one question. When Gertrude came in, she had socks on. Her socks are not gone.
There's an explanation for that.
And the explanation is?
Clearly someone took them.
And
wasn't
who?
Me. Wasn't me.
Really? Are you planning to help take our socks?
Well, it could be. I mean, they do need socks. I've seen a lot of help around here with holes.
Katie, you stole a pair of socks from some chick's funeral? That is vapid, bro!
Someone said that she took them with her to heaven.
You're sick! You're twisted, chick!
I do that all the time. I've never bought...
We should make that a college thing, you know?
Right?
Like, you go to people's funerals and you just steal shit off them, right?
Smell you smell on every single JC.
Well,
right here it says, and other things.
The number of murders that were committed after you fired all those employees.
Yeah, I'm not proud.
The number of people that came through here, man.
Yeah.
I'm gonna send you right to heaven.
Oh wow.
You're a good man.
Thank you. Do I touch you?
You might burn, so
okay,
you might want to be careful.
Hey, I've got number 666. How long is this gonna take?
I'm done, clearly.
Come on in. Come on in.
I drew dicks in online airline magazines. I know it's not the best reason to go to hell, but I mean I'm here. So you got anything you need a dick drawn on? Satan, come on, buddy, you got a good sense of humor, don't you?
I got the letter from Delta.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. They had some huge problems.
So you know my work. All right.
Now, you do still have frequent flyer miles you never cashed in.
Perfect, perfect.
So,
hey, look, let me just ask you. Is there anything I can draw a dick on down here besides you?
Listen, man, you're not going to do that here in hell, all right? People get really angry. You got demons and dragons and shit.
Well, what's going to happen? Am I going to go to hell? Come on, man. Let me draw a dick on something.
All
amazing, don't you think? As the curator of this show, what do you think is the meaning behind the dick?
Well, it's almost endless, you know? I think, you know, you really just pull from it what you will. What I get is, you know, what's represented by the hearty vein is something, you know, it's almost like an ocean, you know? You can keep looking and looking and look for an island in the end, but really, you're just going to see dicks.
You're so profound in the way that you analyze the, you know, the color.
Oh, God.
Yeah, isn't it amazing? It's amazing.
You see that too?
Yeah, it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. Very expressive. Very expressive. I like the color patterns, the shapes that are floating around.
Yeah, but how does it make you feel?
It makes me feel.
Just say it.
Happy?
That's deep.
Isn't that deep? Mm-hmm. Maybe it makes me feel sad. It makes me feel lonely.
Lonely?
Yeah.
Like it's something that you're without? Is it because...
Have you been talking to my mother? Is that what she's been saying?
So, protege, you think you're an artist, huh?
I'm getting there.
You think you know every detail of dick that is needed per painting?
I have studied them for years.
Listen to me. Who the fuck do you think you are, man? I've spent years in dickistry, all right? I have my PhD in looking at dick.
Did you have your name legally changed to Peter Penis like I did?
I did.
Thank you very much.
I did it first, though.
What?
I did it first in court with the bills were paid before yours. The stamp, it was approved, okay?
My life is a sham.
You're not an artist. You're not. You're nothing. You're just gonna paint flowers all day. That's where your career will be.
Really? What are you saying? I'm good enough for flea market? That's
maybe.
It?
Maybe, but you'll never get to the big art galleries in Europe.
Honey, I think your dick sketches are really great.
Thank you so much. I need some support. I mean,
look,
geez,
we'll put it right
please.
On the fridge.
Look.
Huh?
Look, I'm glad you're supportive of them. And you and the kids are great, you know?
Yeah.
It just... I need an outlet, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, you're respected here.
I want to move beyond the fridge gallery, though, you know?
Our son just got suspended because he was bragging about how good your dick pics are.
Was he? Well, I...
Go ahead. Paint me.
Yes.
They said you were the best dick painter ever, and, well, former CEO of JCPenney.
Work is work, right?
Well, that's what I hear.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Make me look good.
You got a little something going down there. A little JC, you got a little JC Penney down there, too. What is that, a little parole special? Oh, up here! Sorry! Huh?
I'm just here because my parole officer sent me.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
Can
nice.
You talk like this? You're like a barber?
Okay, next! Thank you! Thank you! Thanks for coming into the DMV! That's fantastic!
No problem.
I understand, based on us calling number 27, that you want to have your name changed legally.
Yes.
Do you have the forms?
Yes.
Okay, let me see it.
Here.
Okay. C and I see. Oh, wow. You want to change your name to Peter Penis.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, that is a fantastic idea. Can you give me a little history on that name?
Well, I'm an artist who draws penises, so therefore I thought it was apropos.
Okay, so artist... draws penis.
That'll all fit,
wait,
right?
I spelled that wrong. Back it up, okay.
Do
penises.
It.
Penises, okay. All right. Because you're a minor,
yeah.
You're going to need your mom's approval. All right?
What?
Did she come with you?
Yes, I did.
Oh, you're Mr. Penis's mother?
Do you need to see some identification?
I do need to see some identification.
Mom, just show it to him. We run into this all the time.
Okay. See, and so I see your... former name is Smith.
Yes.
And apparently you don't think that's good enough for the world of penis pictures.
I'm not going to limit my baby boy. He can do whatever his heart is set on.
Okay, because he's an artist.
It's more or less going to be a stage name, right, Mom?
Whatever you want, honey. I knew I wasn't there when you were younger, but now I'm just okay with this, I guess.
Listen to me. She's hella
helicopter parenting the shit out of me. I can't take it anymore. I don't want to be Peter Venus.
Sir.
Mom.
Change the name, woman.
Some other guy help me.
Can I get
please
security
help me.
Can I get security and police?
Please.
You're going to need to remove your hand from my shoulder. I'm an official employee of the DMV. We don't want a lab touching here.
Security.
Sir, this is Mr. Peter Penis. He needs to be removed from
lies! This woman assaulted my son!
I did no such thing!
Who is to be removed?
Well, this one wants to change his name
please
to Penis.
Please leave.